B22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace Team, the solution for humanity.
For humanity.
We find more than 461 verses in the Quran that speak about our planet, Earth. And these words, Al-Ard, comes in three meanings. If it comes in comparison with the moon or the sun or the constellations, it means the whole planet. وَفِي الْأَرْضِ آيَاتٌ لِلْمُوقِنِينَ. Verily, in the Earth are signs for those who are truly believing in Allah. And one would ask, why did Allah cause the axial parts of oceans to be physically set on a blaze? The oceans cool gradually with depth, and this is contrary to what we have on land. On land we have a gradual increase in temperature with depth at the rate of 1 degree centigrade every 30 meters. But in the ocean we find gradual cooling, and Allah, out of His mercy, has caused this volcanicity, our volcanic activity at the bottoms of oceans, to go on to warm the water for life at the bottoms of oceans and some of the seas as well, like the Red Sea. So without this volcanicity coming out, life could never have existed at the bottoms of the oceans, especially if we know that the average depth of an ocean is 4 kilometers, and some of the depths in the Pacific Ocean can exceed 11 kilometers. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has caused intensive volcanic activities to take place at the axial parts of oceans so that it can warm the water for life at the bottoms of oceans and seas. And amazingly enough, we know that water covers more than 71% of the surface of the earth, with an average depth of 4 kilometers to more than 11 kilometers. And this immense quantity of water can neither quench the activity of volcanoes at the axial parts of seas and oceans, neither this activity can evaporate that water completely. And this stands as one of the most striking phenomena of our time that surprises all scientists. How on earth could fire and water exist together in one place? Neither the fire can evaporate the water completely, nor the water can quench the fire completely. And this remains as a living testimony to the precision, scientific precision, of this verse in Surah At-Tur, والبحر المسجور. And as I said last time, Allah, all glory be to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not need to give an oath to His creation. But when a Quranic verse comes in the context of an oath, This is one of the ways of directing our attention to the importance of the matter by which the oath is given. So Allah is telling us, look around and see that this is one of the marvels of creation, that water and fire can coexist at the bottoms of all the oceans of your time and the bottoms of some of the seas. And this is one of the great phenomena that can direct the attention of sane people to the marvels of creation and to the knowledge and wisdom and power of the Creator. Of course, I have two documentary films that can document this phenomenon, which many people may not believe in. Another verse reads, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأْتِي الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. Haven't they seen that we come to the earth and reduce it from all its peripheries? And we have another verse that carries the same meaning, أَفَلَا يَرَوْنَا أَنَّا نَأْتِي الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا أَفَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. Early commentators explained these two verses by the death of knowledgeable people, the death of scholars, the death of great scientists and great scholars of Islam. And I dare say that every Quranic verse that comes in the context of a phrase, in the context of a similitude, in the context of a conjecture, it remains scientifically correct, although it comes in the way of giving an example, of simulating something, but it remains scientifically absolutely correct. Reduction of the earth from all its peripheries was explained in different ways. We know that weathering processes, wind, running water, glaciation, gravity, variation in temperature between day and night, and between summer and winter, all this can erode the peaks of high mountains and throw the debris into lower areas. And they said this is a way of reducing the earth from all its peripheries. And this is a phenomenon in geology known as peneplanation. These physical processes try to peneplane, to level the surface of the earth. It was said that the earth rotates around its own axis. And as a result of that rotation, it got bulged at the equator and slightly flattened at the two poles. The current difference between the polar axis and the equatorial axis is around 14 kilometers. So we know that really this can maybe taken as a way of reducing the earth from all its peripheries. We know that sea can encroach over land, and this can cause the earth to be reduced from its peripheries. Yet the most sound explanation, all these can be correct, but the most sound explanation to me is that the earth is shrinking from all its peripheries. And earth scientists have come to prove that the early earth was at least 100 times the volume of the current earth, to 200 times. Estimates vary a little bit. 100 to 200 times the volume of the current earth. And the earth is shrinking from all its peripheries, mainly through what it loses via volcanic vents. Light material, light gases, light solid particles that can escape to outer space. And to maintain the earth at a fixed distance from the sun, 150 million kilometers, this has to take place because the sun is losing out of its mass in the form of energy what has been calculated to be around 4.6 billion tons every second. So to keep the distance between the earth and the sun, that fixed distance which Allah has planned, so if the sun is losing every second out of its mass something in the range of 4.6 billion tons, so the earth have to lose a proportional mass so that this distance can remain constant between the earth and the sun. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا. Haven't we made the earth as a leveled plain and mountains as pegs? And it's amazing really for the Quran to spell out these facts. Haven't we made the earth as a leveled plain and the mountains as pegs? In 1992, I wrote a book about mountains in the glorious Quran. And the book was published in Washington, D.C. And I meant by it to be a piece of da'wah for Islam in the language of the time. I collected the definitions of mountains in a large number of books, encyclopedias, dictionaries, in Arabic, English, French, and German. Up until 1990, all these references were describing mountains as surface protrusions, protrusions on the surface of the earth. The Quran, a book revealed more than 14 centuries ago to an unlettered prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an unlettered society, described mountains as pegs or pickets. Inasmuch as the peg has got its shortest length rising above the ground and its greatest length buried in the ground, these wooden pegs that hold the sides of the tent firmly to the ground, it has most of its length buried in the ground. Only very recently, geologists came to discover that that's exactly the shape of rock mountains. Every rock mountain has got the greatest depth buried in the ground and the shortest elevation of it, shortest length of it, rising above the ground. Every mountain has got almost 10 to 15 times its surface elevation above the ground, buried in the ground. And I cannot find a single word that can describe the surface elevation, the downward extension, and the function as the word picket or peg. How on earth could Muhammad, peace be upon him, know this fact that was only disclosed to human knowledge in the latest decades of the 20th century? أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادَ وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا. Haven't we made the earth as a leveled plain? And we know today that the earth started by a highly complex topography, and then Allah caused wind, running water, glaciers, variation in temperature to wear these complexities and peneplane and level the surface of the earth. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادَ وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادَ. Haven't we made the earth as a leveled plain and mountains as pickets or pegs? We can see also in icebergs, not only in rocky mountains and rock mountains, we can see in icebergs that the bulk of the berg is buried in water and the smallest part of it is rising above the sea level. In 42 verses, the Quran describes mountains in a beautiful manner. وألقى في الأرض رواسي أن تميد بكم وأنهارا وسبلا لعلكم تهتدون. Allah has thrown down into the earth stabilizers, meaning mountains, stabilizers lest shake with you.
Muhammad, peace
pearls of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Narrated Huzaifa, may Allah be pleased with him. I heard the Prophet, may peace be upon him, saying, a qatat, that is, the one who conveys false information from one person to another with the intention of causing harm and enmity between them, will not enter paradise. Sahih al-Bukhari, Volume 8, Book of Good Manners, Hadith number 6056.
Mustafa, Mustafa.
Where truth is hidden, misleading quotations create confusion. Where truth is hidden, lack of knowledge and wisdom cause upheaval and commotion. Where truth is hidden, manipulated scriptures and twisted facts emerge. This very hidden truth creates false propaganda, mayhem, chaos, disorder, and turmoil in our lives and the world order. But is there anyone with courage and wisdom? What is the truth, and who has the courage to expose it? Because it's your right to know the truth.
Watch Truth Prevail and Lies Perish in Truth Exposed by Dr. Zakir Naik every Sunday to Friday at 9 p.m. and repeat telecast at 7:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
And this meaning has come several times in the glorious Quran. وَالْجِبَالَ أَرْسَاهَا مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. And by the mountains, Allah has stabilized the earth as a matter of convenience for yourselves and your cattle. وَالْجِبَالَ أَرْسَاهَا مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. Nowadays, we have just come to realize that the continental masses are floating on top of the zone of weakness. And as the earth rotates around its own axis, these continental masses drift away from each other or towards each other. And this drifting, this movement of the continental masses can make life virtually impossible on the surface of the continental masses. No soil could accumulate. No plant could grow. No animal could exist. No human could live. No road could be constructed. No house could be built. So this jerky movement was very rough at the beginning of the creation of the earth. Then Allah stabilized it with mountains. And that's why Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is quoted to have said, عِنْدَمَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْأَرْضَ جَعَلَ التَّمِيدِ فَأَرْسَاهَا بِالْجِبَالِ. When Allah created the earth, it started to shake and jerk. Then Allah stabilized it with mountains. The stabilization of the continental masses with the mountains has been only discovered in the late 60s, early 70s of the 20th century. For the glorious Quran to spell that out is a living testimony that this noble book cannot be the work of man. It's the divine word in its divine purity. I will end one verse that is considered to be one of the most magnificent scientific precedents of the glorious Quran. We read in the Quran that there is a chapter, there is a surah called Surah Al-Hadid, chapter on iron. The chapter number 57. And man knows more than 100 elements, around 105 elements. The only element by which a chapter in the Quran was named, a surah in the Quran was named, is iron. And one would be amazed, why iron? Why did Allah, all glory be to him, has chosen iron to name a chapter in this noble book, which is mainly a book for guidance in areas that cannot be correctly addressed by man, such as the area of faith, the area of acts of worship, the area of the moral code, and the area of the code of transactions with others? Why should this book contain a chapter on iron? And then we read in this chapter, Allah says, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Verily, we have sent our messengers with the clear-cut evidences. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنْزَلْنَا مَعْمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانِ. And we have sent down with them the book and the balance. لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. To establish justice amidst people. وَأَنْزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ. And verily, we have sent down iron, wherein there is mighty strength and many beneficial aspects to mankind. Amazing. The Quran is simulating the sending down of iron to earth. And then we have verily sent down iron, wherein there is mighty strength and many beneficial aspects to mankind. Nowadays, we know that the earth has got 35.9% of its total mass iron. The total mass of the earth is calculated or estimated to be around 6,000 million tons. This means that the earth has got more than 2,000 million tons iron. Most of this iron is in the core of the earth. The earth has got a solid inner core, mainly composed of iron, 90% iron, 9% nickel, and 1% light materials. Then an outer molten core having a similar composition. And then four layers of mantle and the outer rocky cover. So the percentage of iron from the base of the mantle to the crust decreases gradually until it becomes only 5.6% in the outer crust of the earth. Nobody could have ever dreamt of the fact that this iron was physically sent down to earth. How was it sent down? How did it penetrate the outer rocky cover of the earth? How was it concentrated in the core of the earth? How its percentage started to minimize from inside outwardly if it was sent from outside? So all commentators on the glorious Quran said, sent down here is metaphoric. It means we have created iron with these qualities. We have made iron with these qualities. But before space travel, space scientists worried about rocky particles that travel in outer space, meteors and meteorites. They were absolutely worried. Some of these meteorites come down to Earth in hundreds of tons of pure iron. And if a meteor of that mass would hit a spaceship, it would destroy it completely. They started studying where these meteorites come from. For their surprise, they came to realize that our sun has no iron. It does not generate iron. And our Earth is separate from the sun. So if the Earth was separate from the sun, and the sun does not generate iron, where did this massive quantity of iron has come to the Earth? They said it's these meteoric bodies. Where does these or do these meteoric bodies come from? They came to realize that iron is only created in the cores of stars much greater than the sun during its explosion, what's known as the supernova stage. When core of the supernova changes into iron, it consumes its energy. So this core explodes once more, and the core is shattered to pieces that travel into outer space. And Allah will send it to heavenly bodies or in the earth, which Allah knows that it needs that iron. This observation has convinced scientists to believe that when the earth was separated from the sun, it was no more than a heap of ash. A heap of ash containing nothing heavier than aluminium. Then it was bombarded by iron meteorites. And by virtue of its density, these iron particles went to the core, penetrated that heap of ash, and went to the core of the earth. It started to melt by the heat of settlement, and caused that heap of ash to melt as well, and to be differentiated into seven earths. A solid inner core, mainly composed of iron and nickel, a molten outer core, mainly composed of iron and nickel, then four layers of mantle, wherein the percentage of iron decreases gradually outwardly, and then outer rocky cover of the earth with only 5.6% of iron. And it has been scientifically proved that all the iron in our earth and in our solar system was physically sent down to us. Who would have known this more than 40 centuries ago, other than the Creator himself? I will add here, فيه بأس شديد, wherein there is mighty strength. Scientists have recently discovered that the binding force of the elementary particles in the nucleus of the iron atom is the highest for any known element. And probably this has given iron certain physical chemical characteristics that distinguishes it from any other known element, and many beneficial aspects to mankind, because iron, without the iron core of the earth could have never attracted its atmosphere or its hydrosphere or its biosphere. Iron constitutes the most of the red material in our blood and in the animals' blood, most of the green material in plants. Iron represents the backbone of industry. So because of this, Allah has said, وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ. I will stop here, hoping that I have made this story clear to you. وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.
Jazakallahu khaira, Dr. Zaghlul al-Najjar. We will now have time for question and answers. So we will have the first question from the front mic.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Afzal Sheikh and I'm a student of commerce. As a child, I've been always taught that it's this earth which rotates around itself and around the sun, and that is how we get day and night every day. But recently, on a Friday, in one bayan, I've heard that it's the sun which rotates around the earth, and that is how we get day and night. So I'm confused which one is true.
If I understood your question clearly, the Earth rotates around its own axis and revolves around the Sun. But the Sun also, with all its planetary system, runs around the axis of the galaxy. So everything in the universe is running, is rotating around its own axis and running in its own orbit. Every single planet or star or moon, everything rotates around its own axis and runs in its own orbit.
Thank you.
The next question from the sister.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Uzma Khan. I'm a student of TYBSC. My question is, the Quran uses the Arabic word ard, which is generally translated as earth. But word ard also means land. So could it be that Quran is referring to other lands besides earth, that is the other planets? Jazakallah.
Jazakum. As I said in my talk, the word al-ard in the Quran comes with three different meanings. If it comes in comparison with the moon or the sun or other planets, it means the whole planet. If it comes without reference to comparison, it's either the continental masses we live on or the soil section that covers that rocky layer. The Quran says, فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءِ اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ. When we send down water to it, it shakes and jerks. Definitely, it's not the total planet that shakes and jerks. What shakes and jerks is the soil section. So it does not mean to other planets. It means to this earth, either the planet or the rocky cover or the soil section covering these rocks.
The next question from the sister.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaykum as-salam.
Jazakallah, Shaykh, for your very reflective talk.
Barakallah feek.
The documentaries you mentioned in the process of your talk, are they accessible through the World Wide Web?
Oh yes, they are very well accepted all the world over. It's not, I do not take it
are
myself.
Are they accessible through the internet?
If anybody would like to have a copy, I give a complete copy to the organizer here. They can give you a copy of it. I have three documentaries on the sea, physically set on a blaze.
Jazakallah.
Very precious.
This life is a gift from Allah.
Utilize this gift for here and hereafter.
Enjoy this gift in the light of the Quran and Hadith.
Enjoy Islam with us, Zain and Dawood.
Enjoying Islam with Zain and Dawood every Monday at 7:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 10:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Thursdays provide.
In Britain, we are facing one big problem, that are you Muslim or British?
The space to talk.
In India, back home, they ask, are you a Muslim first or Indian first? And we Muslims should know how to reply, how to turn the tables over.
The place to knock.
Why Trinity cannot be regarded in that sense, Father, Son and Holy Spirit?
The opportunity to ask.
But even if we agree that what the Christians say, that he was crucified, so if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, died for 3 days, who controlled the world? That means even God died?
The freedom to unmask.
So there are various ways which we can prove the argument to be wrong.
Let's meet Dr. Zakir every Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.